Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. In this video, I am going to demonstrate you how you can use array of structure in C programming. Before starting, you can note how you can search my YouTube channel. You can type my name Sanjay Gupta in YouTube search bar. My channel will be available there. You can watch various programming related videos there. Now I am going to demonstrate you how you can use array of structure in C programming. So first I have included a header file, that is stdio.h. Now I have to declare a structure. So for example, I am using complex structure. In complex number, there are two members, real and imaginary. So I have declared two variables, int r and int I. Then I have terminated structure declaration. Now I am going to define main function. Inside main function, if I write this struct complex e, it means I have declared a variable of data type struct complex. So this C can store only one complex number, that is one real and one imaginary value. But I want to store five complex numbers. So now I have converted C into array of structure. So this notation is array of structure. So this C variable can store five real and five imaginary numbers for five different complex numbers. Now I am going to implement a loop which will repeat five times. Inside this loop, first I am going to display a message, enter %d complex number, and then I plus 1. So value of I is initially 0, but I want to print the message enter first complex number. That's why I have used I plus 1. So I is 0. So 0 plus 1, 1 will be displayed. Then next time I will be 1. So 1 plus 1, 2 will be displayed. And to receive values from user, I have to write scanf statement, which will store elements like this. So now I am going to convert this I into img, imaginary. This I have done because I am also using I variable. So to remove confusion, I am using img for imaginary and I for index. So this way, real and imaginary values of different complex numbers will be stored at I index of C array into r and img variables. Now after reading, I can display all these values which are provided by user on output screen. So I am first going to print a general message, all complex numbers are. Then I am applying a for loop. Inside this for loop, I am going to display real and imaginary values which are available in C array. So this way, complex number equals to %d, then %d I. And comma C of I dot R, comma C of I dot img. So this way, real and imaginary values of this C array for different indexes will be displayed on output screen. So this %d, first %d will be displaying real value, second %d will be displaying imaginary value, and then iota. So this way, all the complex numbers will be displayed on output screen. At last, I am writing return 0. So this is the simple example of using array of structure in C programming. Now I am going to execute this code. So you can see it is asking for first complex number. So I am entering 5, 5. 5 as real, 5 as complex. Now second complex number 6, 6. Third 7, 7. Fourth 8, 8. Fifth 9, 9. You can see the output. All complex numbers are complex number. First is 5, 5 I. Then 6, 6 I. Then 7, 7 I, then 8, 8 I, and 9, 9 I. So first column is printing real, second column is printing imaginary, and then iota. So this way I have printed the output. If you want to modify the printing format, then you can change these %d, %d and I location. So this way you can print all the outputs on output screen with the help of this printf. And I have used array of structure to store 5 different complex numbers together. So this is the use of array of structure in C programming. I hope you have understood how I have implemented this program. If you want to watch more programming related videos, you can search Sanjay Gupta in YouTube, and you can watch various programming related videos in my channel. Thank you for watching this video.